Miss Knight coming to you to share a math lesson today. So let's get busy. So we're going to start out with our learning target. And our learning target tells us you will be able to relate counting groups of tens to subtract multiples of 10. So in our learning target, there are three words that I would like to share with you. One is relate. Relate means to compare to each other, meaning something has to be similar or alike. And then our next word is multiples. Multiples mean groups of something. In our case, it's tens. And then the last word, subtract. You want to take away from a whole number, which is the largest number. So let's talk about some behaviors. So the first thing I want you to do, I want to make sure you're sitting up straight. I want you to block out all distractions. That meaning your TV should be off. No one should be around you disturbing you. And there should be absolutely no noise so that you can pay attention. You want to watch the screen the whole time so that you don't miss anything with your eyes. Then I want you to listen carefully with your ears and make sure you hear everything I'm saying. So, Miss Knight, what will you teach us today? I'm glad you asked. Today I'm going to teach you how to subtract with multiples of 10 at 75% accuracy. So let's talk about what you already know. You're already a genius when it comes to separating tens from ones on a number chart. And you are brilliant when you are adding tens and ones. So today, we're going to do subtracting two-digit numbers with zero. Zero being the relating number, and it's in the ones place. So let's go over today's plan before we get started. First, I will model two problems showing how to subtract using multiples of 10. Then, I will have you to help me to do two problems of subtracting multiples of 10. Finally, you will work on your own with subtracting multiples of 10. Remember, that's those four problems. Okay, so let's get started. So this is an I do time, meaning you will watch with no talking, meaning you will watch my thinking so that you can think the same way when you're working your problem out or some way similar. So my problem says 70 minus 30 equals blank. So this is where I talk to myself, but you don't say anything. So how am I going to solve this problem? I'm going to make a drawing and I'm going to use my place value rods. So 70 minus 30. Let me think. What do I do first? I have to start off with the largest number. And the largest number is 70. So I'm going to make rods for 70. And listen as I count. 10. 20. 30. 40. 50, 60, 70. And that minus sign right here, this minus sign tells me that I have to subtract, meaning I have to take away 30. So let me do that right quick. So I'm going to take 30 away. So listen as I count. 10, 20, 30. Okay, so now that I took 30 away from 70, let's see how many I have left. Because remember, this symbol right here tells me that I have to take it away. So let me count. Follow me. 10, 20, 30, 40. Oh, wow. So 70 minus 30 leaves 40. So I'm going to put 40 right here. Okay? So I would like to do another problem for you. So this is I do again and you watch. So now I'm looking at my subtraction problem and it says 60 minus 60 equals blank. So remember the first thing that I do, I have to draw my rods. So I have to draw out rods to add up to 60. So let's do that now. 10, watch me as I count, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay, so I have 60 in rods. So now I have to take 60 away because if you remember, this minus sign tells me I have to take 60 away from 60. So watch me as I count. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Ah, so if I take 60 from 60, I get 0. So that is the answer. But if you notice right here, if you notice, there are two relating numbers, okay? The 60 and the 60. Well, if you take 60 from 60, as you notice, it was zero. It was nothing left, okay? So now I would like to go to the next problem. This is I do and you help me. So I want you to make sure that you are focusing because this is where Ms. Knight needs your help. So the problem reads 40 minus 20 equals blank. So who can tell me what to do first? You are right. I have to take the largest number and make some rods. And the largest number is, right, is 40. So let's make 40 in rods. Let's count together. 10, 20, 30, 40. And our problem asks us to do what? Subtract, meaning take away. You're right. So what do we take away? We have to take away 20, right? Right there. So let's go ahead and do that quickly. Let's count together. 10, 20. And how much does it leave over? Let's count together. 10, 20. So let's go ahead and put the answer right here. The answer is 20. Great job, guys. So guess what? I have one more problem. So this is an I do, and you help me again. Remember the 60 minus the 60? Well, guess what? This time we're going to do 80 minus 80. So what do they have? Great job, relating numbers. These two numbers are the same. So if we have to take the largest number, well, the number is 80, right? So what do? We have to make 80 worth of rods. Let's go. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. So what do now? We have to take 80 away, right? So help me to count. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. And what's our answer? 0. Now, if you see two numbers together, boys and girls, I want you to remember, if you see two numbers, 80 minus 80, you should automatically know that any number taken away from that same number is 0. 80 minus 80 is 0. 1 minus 1 equals 0. any of those, okay? Great job. So remember, you already know how to add tens and ones and how to take away from whole numbers. And you also know how fact families help you to check your subtraction rules.